Hello guys, welcome to Codoid's YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to implement Pico Containers field level dependency injection in Cucumber. To use Pico Container dependency injection in your POM XML, you need Cucumber Pico Container dependency. So the POM XML, what you are seeing now here is the dependency which I'm using here, and then this is the current version of Pico Container dependency. And once you have this dependency in your POM XML, by default you can use whatever objects pages you have in your automation framework. You can create objects in at constructor level, and then what once the object is created in the constructor, you have to assign that in your class properties. If you have more number of pages, the problem is giving those many number of pages in constructor, it's not a viable option. So we have one more other option, that is called field level injection instead of going for constructor level injection. So now I'm going to show you how to set up field level injection in Cucumber. To set up field level injection, a dependency injection, what you have to do is you have to create a file called Pico Dependency Injector. You can give whatever name you want, but it should implement the object factory interface. So here I have three pages. That is, for this example, we have chosen Amazon e-commerce website. So home page, product page, and e-gift card page. So I need all the three pages, and then we have shared driver also. So I need the objects for three pages, and then object for shared driver. Inside the Pico container dependency injection, you have to add this class, and then even if you are adding more number of pages, you have to add those pages here. Since I need only four classes here, so I have added those classes. So the Pico container will serve object for these classes, whichever step definition files access object for these classes. So in order to inform Cucumber, let's say we are using the default Cucumber dependency injection. Now that is constructor level. But we have to inform Cucumber that we are using a custom dependency injector. So for that, you need one file that is called cucumber.properties file. So you have to create that inside the test resources folder, cucumber.properties, and this is the variable and this is the value. So the value is where you have that Pico dependency injector file. The file name, you can give whatever file name you want, and you have to give that package and then the class name here. And one more file is also required, that is that should go inside the resources meta-inf.services folder, and then this is the file name. So io.cucumber.core.backend.objectfactory. So this is the file name and this is the value. These two configurations are very important, that is cucumber.properties and then creating meta-inf.services, and then this is the file name. Inside this, you have to give these values. So don't worry about this configuration. Inside the video description, you have a blog link, Codoid's blog link, where you have the code base for this framework, so you can refer it anytime. So this configuration is very important. So once this is done, you have to go to step definition file, and you no need this constructor at all. All you need to do is you have to use inject annotation before each variable, that is each property. That's it. So what it will do is, like whenever this annotation is called, the object will be served from the Pika container dependency, the Java file. You no need to add, like even if you are adding new pages also, you can use inject annotation instead of giving it in constructor level. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.